Hi, I'm Ted Taft, Jr. Work here at the Portland lab, and we're going to be figuring out how to simulate mechanical pruning for an experiment. What you want to do is cut everything off at the post. And if it is free, leave everything on this side of the post because you generally are taking only readings for whatever thing grew in this post length. But if you've got, and we generally try to have also, if it works out well, you have two people, one on one side of the vine, one on this side, because reaching through sometimes is not all that easy. You also want to bring anything down because you're also figuring that there's the little fingers on the mechanical pruner that will be bringing things down to a point. Then you go along an imaginary line where about where you would want the cutter bars to be coming along the bottom, and you just grab it, which generally is about belt height. And then you have a piler behind you, or you will leave it in a central location for a piler to come when they catch up to you. And then you want about a hand's width between the two vines. You want to maintain vine space. And that'll go straight down as well. And you want about a hand's width in between the two because you want to maintain the space between the two cordons if the vines allow it, if it's not just one cordon. But you want to maintain both sides of the vine. And you clean off the trunks. And there you basically have it. Now the piler will come along behind you, or while they're still here. Take out all of last year's wood. Turn it into a bundle that then can be weighed. There. You can also make it neater, depending on how much time you want to take. Again, you take the hand, bringing it down so it's about clear. Boot length, or a belt length. This one you see is a little more confusing with the two cordons, but you do the best you can with it. Anything that goes like here goes back on itself. You want to get rid of that. Either by bringing it down and cutting it or cutting it off where you want the space between the cordons. Now you can either hand it to your piler or just make, as I said, make the pile. There. Questions, observations, problems? You raised your hand.
For the good of the class, first year wood, separating out first year wood if you're a piler. So what are your telltale signs?
This year's wood theoretically will either look like this yellowy, not ripe stuff that's dead, and the rest will be this nice chestnut brown. Last year's will have the bark will be peeling on it for the most part like this. That's the stuff you don't want to save. The rest, you want to save everything that's been grown this year. This year's vegetative growth. And you also see what way it comes out of little canes like this. This is last year's, the stuff we saved. This is this year's. Notice the nice chestnut color. And with here, you can see where this was still growing before it froze. And right there's the paraderm line. This is the ripe, mature wood. This is the stuff that didn't get ripe and is dead. They'll turn gray by the end of the season. If anybody has questions, you may leave them in the comments below.